Hello, everybody. Welcome to our session. Tonight's session is to help you relax as deeply as you can. And I suspect that's pretty deep. It's also for people who tend to carry their stress, maybe discomfort, maybe even pain in their neck and shoulders. That's where I carry mine the most. And so I can probably relate to some of you. Here I am finishing up cleansing our spaces and our fields so that we can easily and safely begin our work today. I'm going to use my pretty candle today. And so let's set our intention. If you have a different intention, you can always set that with this video as well, as long as it's for the highest and finest good of all. So for the highest and finest good of all, the intention for this video is to help you release stress, pain, overthinking, trauma from those areas pertaining to the neck and shoulders and upper back as well. I'm going to take the candle around to begin the fire element cleansing process. All right, I'm going to put this down. Like hematite today that I am. I think I tap it better with my right hand. And this stone is very protective as it is grounding. As we pull that negative energy down and off, maybe you can imagine releasing some tension in those shoulders. If you normally wear your shoulders like earrings, just pull them down a little bit. Just as quick or slow as you can. Slow is usually better. I know I like to just every once in a while do a little stretch for my neck and a roll with my shoulders. I'm going to put this by your feet. All right in between. And next, we have the blue kyanite. Which helps align all of the chakras, help balance the energy field. And I'm going to place this over your solar plexus. Okay. Blue kyanite can also strip off kind of like wood. I got a little bit out in my hand. Okay. So now I have moon water, little peacock ore, and clear quartz. And some tea tree and rosemary. I'm going to spray it, but not directly at you. It's going to be to the side. Okay. And that smell is so purifying. So relaxing. I'm just going to make sure your shoulders just bringing those shoulders down again. If they've lifted up, it's okay. I can get behind in between those shoulder blades. I'm reaching behind you. Let's take the selenite wand through your field. Smoothing your energy. Thank you. relaxing. You're safe. If you're watching this, you're probably not being bothered by anybody else. So you can just let go for these next few minutes. Now let's see what we can take off those areas. Now, so mostly what we'll be working with the throat chakra and the heart chakra as it pertains to the throat and shoulders. Our neck and shoulders, and also with the third eye chakra, as that's where our thoughts apply that tension from. When I get stressed in these areas, I'm sometimes reacting with a thought or feeling. Well, there has to be a thought to get a feeling. Because of an unfortunate situation or somebody's just being rude, so I don't know if I'll be able to get the whole sound out of the video, but my year-old lab is becoming obsessed with squirrels, and he has the most peculiar growl. It sounds like gurgling. I just let him out to go play. So you won't be able to see my hands as much because I'm at your shoulders. There's some of you with your heart. What is it? Is yearning for something? Hopefully we can soothe that area so that you can relax and sleep better. This agate, and I'm going to place the Reiki symbols in your heart chakra. Chakra. Thank you. and I have the Sacred Traveler Oracle cards today. Let's see where we're might be going. So the first card I got is Solitude. In silence, peace prevails, it says. And the second one says, it's crossing bridges. It's time for healing, connecting, mending and releasing. These are some great cards for today's session. Okay, Solitude. In silence, peace prevails. In silence, you'll find a depth of self-awareness as well as inner peace. This is not a time to venture forth with a new project or a new cycle. This is the time to step back and be still. In quietude, you can work and uncover your deepest inner truth. Seek solitude, and all will be renewed. No matter what is happening around you, find serenity. Your power is born in stillness. Sometimes the traveler is in such a hurry to reach the next peak that he or she gets separated from the spiritual source. However, when the traveler takes time alone, everything falls into perspective. Take time out of your day to be completely quiet. Take deep, slow breaths. Imagine inhaling vitality and exhaling all that is not needed. Affirm that all is well. Move past the chatter and chaos on the road of life. Be still and hear the source of your higher self and your spirit guides. And crossing bridges. Time for healing, connecting, mending, and releasing. Crossing bridges is a way to let go of the past and begin a new cycle in life. A heartfelt change is ahead. It's time for healing old wounds with people and situations. It's time to forgive and let go of the past. Do whatever you need to do to make amends and then let it all go. If there is anything unresolved in your life, take steps to restore and reconcile. You may even need to burn your bridges behind you. Heal the rifts within yourself. Help others traverse bridges in their lives. When the traveler crosses a bridge, a new land awaits on the other side. You're ready to cross a bridge or bridge a gap in your life. There are times to step away from certain people and situations. There are also times to carefully mend bridges with people, situations, and places. And then go forward. This is one of those powerful healing times to choose. Maybe there is a wound inside of you that needs to be forgiven or accepted. Transform the inner grievance. Forgive, let it go, do it now. You no longer need to carry it with you. Perhaps there is a person from your past with whom you should reconnect or release completely. You know what you need to do. This is the time to do it. Really great cards for today. So, the black kyanite, I'm just going to scrape along here to make sure we got everything. We'll draw everything out and basically chop it off so that it cannot be reconnected to. That's just the negative energy. We don't want it reconnecting. And this is a crystal for overthinkers. It helps calm the mind, calm any worry. find this crystal so soothing for this area. And I think some of you are letting go enough for the rest of your body to also let go. You're doing so beautifully. This stone can help transmute and help you let go of all types of situations, including helping to clear and energize the throat chakra from what we say to ourselves, all the nasty little things that we can say to ourselves sometimes get stuck in that throat chakra area. And this helps clear it out and re-energize the goodness of that chakra. I think of this as a stone for healing trapped energy. I think I've said this a few times before. It reminds me of a cage. So something is trapped. It could be trapped negative energy. It could be trapped good energy that needs to get out and expand as well. behind you. Going to continue playing the background sound for a little bit after the video ends, just so that you can rest and sleep easier.